Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And this is our second tutorial on setting up the development environment. And this time we are going to use Visual Studio and we will also install some dependencies like Office SharePoint and C# with .NET. So let's get started and I will show you all the steps because I am going to install that on my PC where I have freshly installed Windows 11. So you can see all the steps from the beginning. So here in the Microsoft Edge browser, I will look for download Visual Studio. Only Visual Studio, not code. I have shown that how you can install Visual Studio code in my previous video. You can go and watch that video, and that was also our first video about setting up the development environment to create Office add-ins specifically. So I will press the enter key. So the top link is about Visual Studio for Mac. I am using Windows, so I can either use this download link or I can move to their official website to download a particular version of Visual Studio. So I will advise you to go to their official website so we can choose a specific version to download. So here you can see that we have three different versions: community, professional and enterprise. So as if a student, if you are trying the Visual Studio 2022 as a student or a open source contributor or as an individual, then you must install this version. Otherwise, there are professional and enterprise version which are paid. You can see that you can try the free versions as well for a particular trial period. So I will go with this one, the community version, which you can download for free and can use for free if you are an individual or a student or even a contributor. So instead of saving this executable file, I will directly open it from this link. So because I don't want to save the installer, because most of the installation is going to be online, so it is best to run the installer instead of saving and then running it. So it is saying that before we begin, we need to configure a few things before the installation, and we will click on the continue button. So you can see that basically it is downloading the Visual Studio installer, which is a very nice application to install various aspects of Visual Studio. Like you can install libraries, dependencies easily from the Visual Studio installer. And you can see that we have now the Visual Studio Community 2022. So now it is asking us to choose workloads and select a particular development environment that we want to use and for which we want to create solutions. So as I have shown in my previous tutorial that how you can install Node.js, but that was a part of the installation where you were particularly using Node.js with Yeoman generator. But if you want to develop the same solution using Visual Studio, then you can also make a check mark on here, and then you will be able to open the Node.js projects within Visual Studio. So for now, I will first go with the Office SharePoint development. That is the first thing that we need to check here. And the second thing is, I also would like to go with the C# and .NET development. I will also make a check mark on here. And you can see that total space required is 8.43 GB and it is going to take a lot of time to install. And it is also asking us that if I want to install while downloading or I want to download and then install. So I will go with this option. I want it to download the entire project and then start the installation. So I will now click on the install button and we are going to install two development environments in Visual Studio. That is, first is the .NET and the second which we need, that is Office SharePoint. And now I will click on the install button to begin the installation, and it is going to take a lot of time, so I will skip this part. So after that, I will show you that how you can create your first PowerPoint web heading using Visual Studio. Do also note that Visual Studio installer is now also installed on your system. Visual Studio installer. And you can also open this application later on to install other dependency if you may require any to develop any new solutions inside Visual Studio. So as you install new dependencies, you will find that there are new templates available when you open Visual Studio and start creating a new project. So as we have checked the Office SharePoint development environment, now when we will run Visual Studio, you will see a lot of ready-made templates will appear when we will start creating a new project. And as we have also checked the .NET framework with C# and VB.NET, you will also see a lot of templates, ready-made templates in the new project section. So as you install these new dependencies or development environment, you will see new templates inside the new project section. So that way it becomes very easy for you to get started with the new project easily. So depending on how many development environments you have selected during the installation, it will take the time accordingly. And it also depends on your internet speed, and you have might have seen that my internet was giving around 25 MB average speed, and that was 25 megabytes. So my currently the internet plan that I am currently using is a 200 Mbps plan, and they also offer us the 5G connection. Even after a speed of 25 megabytes per second, you can see that still it is taking a lot of time because both the development environment was taking a space of around 8.43 GB. And after downloading that much of data, it also needs some time to install all of them properly so you can open and use them in just a few clicks. I am also really excited to try the PowerPoint add-ins inside Visual Studio. So that is why I am waiting to I am waiting for this installation to get complete, so I may try my hands in the development using Visual Studio. And I will show you that it is more easier than using the command line tools like Node.js with the human generator. However, you can also use Visual Studio code, as I have shown you in my previous video, that if you are using Node.js with the human generator, then you can use Visual Studio code for that to edit your coding files. On the other hand, if you want to go with the Visual Studio 2022, the development edition, then it will also make your life a little bit easy, because you will, the first thing that you will notice is the ready-made templates that you can use, select and create. And most of these templates are ready to use, like they have some sample codes in them, and you can run those templates right after creating them to test them inside the applications. Like the PowerPoint add-in that I will show you after the installation will complete, I will show you that how quickly you can set up your new project to create like a PowerPoint web add-in. You can see that how many packages are getting installed in the backend, and they are also displaying the name of each of the package as well. The good thing is that the developer edition is free, so you don't need a license for that, and you can try it for as much time as you want. So I have to sign in to use Visual Studio, and you can use the Microsoft account like Hotmail, Live.com or Outlook.com, I think. So it will sign me in automatically because I am already logged into my Amazon account. inside. I am using Windows 11, and for login, I am using my MSN live account, not a local account. Maybe it will not ask me for the credentials because I have already filled them. So it is trying to log me in. No, I have to fill them again. So here we are inside Visual Studio 2022. And here we have the Get Started window with four options. And here at the bottom we have Create a New Project. And we will start with this Create a New Project. And now you can see Recent Project Templates. And that is what I was talking about, that we have installed two development platforms. One is C# with .NET and another was Office with SharePoint. So you can see these templates right here, the C# templates for other application as well, not only the Office add-ins, for all type of applications that can be developed using C# and .NET. And now I will show you the Office SharePoint templates you can find here. So let's say I find for PowerPoint. So here you can see that we have four different types of PowerPoint templates ready to be used. So we have PowerPoint web add-in with C#, we have PowerPoint VSTO add-in with C#, PowerPoint web add-in with Visual Basic, and PowerPoint VSTO add-in with Visual Basic. So let's say I go with PowerPoint web add-in using C# and click the next button. So I will give a name to my first PowerPoint add-in that I am creating through Visual Studio. Click the create button after typing the name, and you can also see the location where your repository is going to be saved with this name, sample web add-in. So when creating a PowerPoint web add-in using C#, you are going to see this dialog window where it will ask you that either you want to add new functionalities to window that will create a task pane web add-in for PowerPoint, or you want to insert content into PowerPoint slides, and that will also create a task pane, but that task pane will be embedded into your PowerPoint slide. So first I will show you this one. In this video we will talk about more features of Visual Studio and creating Office add-in using Visual Studio in our next videos. I was just telling you that how you can use Visual Studio 2022, how you can download and install it, and how you can set up your first project using ready-made templates. So I will click the finish button, and as soon as I will click the finish button, you will see that how it will create your new repository inside this profile folder of mine. That is Rajiv Kohli. I will open the File Explorer window, and here I will show you the main profile folder, which is usually in C, Users, Rajiv Kohli. And here you can find that source folder under which repos, and here we have a separate subfolder, sample web add-in. And you can see that it has started creating a lot of files and subfolder inside it. So once it will get completed, you will see the project window, the Visual Studio project window, where you will find all the features and options and the coding methods that you can use to develop your project. So even if you are a beginner, you can still try all this. And later in our next videos, we will use ChatGPT to help us to build new solutions. So here we have our new PowerPoint web add-in task pane project. And without telling you anything about the solution explorer or something, I will just show you that how you can start this template by clicking on the start button, and it will begin the development environment and will also start the debugging. If it will find any issue, you can find the details of those issues in the output pane here that you can see at bottom. So you can also see in the Solution Explorer that it has created all the necessary dependency files for you. And it is asking me for the SSL certification verification. I will say yes. I trust this certificate. And you can also find all of these files inside your project folder as well. Let me refresh it. You can see that. So now it is currently building the project. And now you can see that it has automatically opened the Microsoft PowerPoint. And you will see your project running as it. And here we now have a new button called Show Task Pane in the Home tab of the Office ribbon. And now we have a dialog box appearing stating Get Started with your sample add-in. Your sample add-in is loaded successfully. Go to the Home tab and click Show Task Pane button to get started. So you can, anytime you can click on this button to reload your sample web add-in. It got errors. I think the development server has stopped, so I will close the application and will rerun the add-in. Now this time it will start a little bit faster. So as I had told you earlier that this is a ready-made template for getting started and click to use. So if let's say I type some text here in the text box and select this text box and click on this button, get data from selection, then you can see that it fetched that text from the slide and displaying that to you in a message box inside the task pane. So that was just a sample project to get started with Visual Studio and start creating your first PowerPoint web add-in. So in my next tutorial, I will also show you how you can create your first PowerPoint VSTO add-in, which is Visual Studio Tools for Office. And I hope you will find this video informative and interesting. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And do not forget to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye and take care.